Robbie, can I get you some dressing for yourself?
Yeah, yeah, bring them on out. Hey. Girl, I think they're...
Are we shooting?
Aren't we on lunch break?
Yeah, let's just go.
Okay.
Hello and welcome to Wolf Ridge in the North Shore. My name is Caroline.
My name is Robbie, and we'll be your naturalist today as we talk about food and farming. Look at that.
Oh my gosh, we even have our lunch brought to you by the Wolf Ridge Farm.
I think we should go back in time here and travel to the farm and see where these greens came from.
Let's do it.
Hey, Sarah.
Hey, Robbie. Welcome back to the farm.
Thanks. It's good to be here.
Gosh, I'm glad you're here, but I thought Caroline was coming with you.
Yeah.
Hey, Sarah.
Oh, hi, Carol.
Let us know what you do at the farm.
Yeah, you bet. So, my name is Sarah Meyer. I'm the farm manager here at Wolf Ridge. My job is to grow vegetables. So, we have a planting plan for each season, and we gather as many helpers as possible. And all that food that gets harvested goes up to the ridge. Do y'all want to take a tour?
Yes.
Definitely.
Okay, let's do it. At Wolf Ridge Farm, we grow vegetables both in our high tunnels and in the field. The advantage of growing in the high tunnels is they're covered, mostly with plastic, and that really protects the plants from the wind, and it also protects the plants from the wildlife, but it really extends the season. Our season isn't much more than 3 months, so we can plant maybe more than 3 months, more like 5 months out of the season, and grow more vegetables that way. There are two structures at Wolf Ridge Farm that really support our operations. The buzz happens in the pack shed. In the pack shed, we pack our vegetables and we send them up to the dining hall for consumption. But we also start our plants there. So we seed everything that we plant out into the field in the high tunnels. We also house our commercial kitchen in there so we can process the vegetables and we can also make pizza. When we make the pizza, we send the pizza out to the timber frame. The timber frame is our classroom. So the classroom is also our lunch space and it holds the pizza oven. So we can make our pizzas there, enjoy lunch, and learn all at the same time. At Wolf Ridge Farm, we grow soil. Well, we do grow vegetables too, but this is where it starts. It starts with the soil. And there's so much life in this soil here, billions and billions of creatures. I actually can't see them, they're microscopic. But there's bacteria and fungi and, oh, maybe a worm. Yep, we'll put that one back. So we have all kinds of life in our soil, but we have to build it. So the soil here in tiers will hold all of the tomatoes we're gonna grow this year. So it's really important that we add nutrients. Now, what we're gonna add to the tunnel in here is compost, and it's magic. So we get a high quality compost that's actually made from cow manure. Super rich, and it makes the plants really happy, and we grow the biggest tomatoes in town.
Vegetable life here at the farm starts with the seed. We also use a germination chamber, and that's what starts this seed. It keeps it warm and cozy, and then it can grow really strong and fast. So we have the advantage of controlling everything here in the pack shed so that these plants can grow as fast and as efficient as possible. And that makes our job really easy.
Well, I've just opened the door to the Chamber of Secrets. Shh. The seeds are still sleeping. Nothing has germinated yet. Oh, soon though, I can feel it. It's really warm. It's about 80 degrees in this chamber and it's really high humidity, just shy of raining. So we're probably about 98% humidity. And we'll just wait. We'll check it every day and see when those seeds start to germinate. After the seeds have germinated, we take them from the germination chamber and bring them out to the grow lights on these racks here. They'll spend anywhere from, a week to 2 months here before they go out into the soil. Thank you. these tomatoes are about ready to go in the ground. They've been in the pack shed for, gosh, I think a couple months. One way we can check to make sure is root growth. And those are beauties. That's a lot of root growth. So if you can pull them right out of the pot and they're all intact, we know they're ready to go. So they'll go into the field, but before they do that, we've got to do a lot of work. Bed prep. So with bed prep, we broad fork the soil. We add compost. And then we mix it with a tiller. And then we use the roller dibbler. Well, after all that excitement of transplanting, we have the plants in the field, and now we have to take care of them. They're our babies, and we're gonna grow them till they're full grown, and then we're gonna harvest and eat them. Woo! So we put the drip irrigation on them so we can run our well water through the headers, and it goes through the drip tape, and it just drips, drips, drips. So it's a nice, deep, even watering. The other thing that we have to do is weed.
At the Finland Cooperative General Store, the oldest continuously run co-op in the United States. And today we've got some of the farm's produce to sell to the local town. Let's do it. So this is where we're gonna sell the farm's produce. And today we're selling pea shoots. We're gonna put those right here. And those pea shoots have only traveled 5 miles from where they were grown to get to the store.
Most people are surprised to learn that most of the food that you find at a grocery store and that you eat at home is not grown in the United States. We import a lot of our food from other countries, and that's what ends up in our grocery stores. Over half of the fruits and over a third of the vegetables in our grocery stores are imported. Buying produce from local farmers. That supports people in your area. It also reduces pollution from the transportation it takes to get your food to you. And you're even gonna be eating tastier and more fresh food. Now that we've got some food waste here, let's take it out to our compost pile. Let's go.
Here at Wolf Ridge, we like to turn our food scraps into nutrient-rich soil.
We like to throw in all of our food waste from the dining hall into this compost pile. That food waste is a nitrogen source. We also add a carbon source, such as paper, and then those things get placed in here to decompose. Underneath this top layer, it gets really hot, and all of that food turns into beautiful, rich soil. It doesn't even look like food scraps at all anymore.
Oh yeah, this stuff looks good. It doesn't get much more local than growing it yourself. In order to grow some microgreens of your own, all you need is a container about an inch deep, some potting soil or compost, and some seeds. All right, growing your own microgreens, step one. We're going to fill our container with just an inch or two of some potting mix. And our seeds today are sunflower seeds, which have been soaking overnight to help them germinate. And I'm gonna put in 2 cups, and you can just sprinkle these right on top. And to help keep these seeds moist, which will help them germinate, we're just gonna finish with a little more potting mix on top. This will just tuck the seeds in, keep them warm, moist, help them germinate. And finally, we'll soak them. Once you've soaked your seeds, you can set them in a warm, sunny spot next to a window and wait for them to germinate. After a week to 10 days, when your microgreens are a couple inches tall and looking super yummy, you can harvest them. You can take a serrated kitchen knife like this or a pair of scissors. Cut them close to the base. Make sure you don't pull up any soil. And now these are good to eat.
Watching plants grow is a great way to use your nature journal. I also planted some seeds just like Robbie did, and I took notes in my nature journal about what I saw each day, and I even added little sketches and notes in to record what I saw.
Thanks for joining us, everyone, for Food and Farming. We hope you learned a lot, and we'll see you next week.
Join us for when we explore spring plants.
Carol, watch out!
What?
Careful, look what you almost stepped on.
Stepped on what?
Those beautiful flowers right there, the spring ephemerals. For only a couple weeks of the year, the most beautiful flowers in the world are in bloom, and you're gonna step on them?
Oh, they are such pretty flowers.
Yeah.
But I think we don't see a lot of plants from the desk. We've been here for a while. Let's go outside.
All right, let's go. What are you gonna plant?
That's a silly question.
An egg?
Totally. You know how much I love birds.
Yeah, but Carol,
I'm gonna grow a bird tree!
Well, it looks like our transplants are ready to go in the ground. Yep, that's all I got.